This SQL tricky question is from Deloitte interview. The task is to delete products from the products table where the expiry date column is less than or equal to the current date. Keep in mind that the expiry date column is located in the stock table. I'll discuss the more challenging part in just a moment, so keep watching. Before we begin, a big thanks to our sponsor, Odin School. They offer a range of IT courses to jumpstart your career with their data science course, preparing you for both data science and data analysis roles. The next cohort starts on 28 September, so don't miss out. Odin School provides live doubt clarification sessions, not just theory, complete practical real-time projects, and over 60 practice and aptitude tests. You will also have live instructor-led classes on weekends. Their 360-degree placement assistant gives you access to a dedicated job application portal with 100-plus job opportunities at top companies like Google, TCS, Capgemini, Accenture, and Tech Mahindra. Plus, they offer career services including aptitude tests, interpersonal skills training, communication workshops, mock interviews, and resume building. Now for payment options. Option number one, pay 75,000 rupees plus GST, but take advantage of their early bird offer for 10,000 rupees discount. Reserve your seat with just 5,000 plus GST with an EMI plan to 3 to 12 months. Option number two, Odin School is so confident in placing you that they offer a pay on success option. 40,000 rupees plus GST upfront, and you pay the balance only after you secure a job. If you're interested, just fill in your detail and request a call back. It's shown on the screen now. Check out the link in the description to reserve your spot. Now, let's get back to the tutorial. I'm 100% confident you might not be aware of these secret SQL delete tricks. Let's begin. To simplify the concept, I have renamed the tables. So, how do we typically delete rows from a table? This will delete a row from medicine table where medicine ID is 100. But what if, let's say I want to delete all the medicine's records which has expired today using the SQL delete statement. This would be simpler if all the data is stored in a single table. But in the real world, this doesn't happen. We store data in multiple tables and we often use SQL join operations to combine those tables and retrieve the desired results. Let's say I have these two tables, medicines and stocks. Here you can observe that the medicine's expiry date is stored in the stock table, while we need to remove data from the medicine table. To accomplish this task, we must perform a table join. There are two methods to achieve this task, the traditional approach and the hidden trick I mentioned earlier. The conventional method involves using a common table expression, also known as CTE. Here is how it works. First, we write a SQL select statement to retrieve all medicine records that have expired today or earlier. This is a simple select statement that returns the medicine ID from the medicine table. We join it to filter out only those medicines that have expired today or on a date before today. Before we proceed, leave a comment and let me know which type of SQL join operation is performed in this query. Now, let's transform this into a CTE. It's quite simple. Just write with expired underscore medicine as and enclose the select statement within parentheses. Here, with and as are keywords and expired underscore medicines is the name I have given to this CTE. If you want to learn more about CTE, you can watch my video. Link is on your screen and in the description. Next, we will write our delete statement. This is a standard delete statement. After the in keyword inside the parentheses, we will provide a select statement that will return all medicine IDs values retrieved by our CTE. Upon execution, all medicines that have expired will be deleted from the medicine table. But here is a catch. Now it's time to unveil the second part of the question, which is the actual challenge. In the interview question, it's explicitly stated that candidates must perform this delete operation without using CTE or select statement. Let's go ahead and do it. It's simpler than it may sound. To achieve this, we will utilize a hidden trick of the SQL delete statement, SQL delete with the using clause. We use SQL delete with using clause when we need to delete records from a table based on a condition involving another table. It's a way to perform a delete operation with a join-like functionality. This is a simple delete statement. First, we specify the table from which we want to delete data, which in this case is the medicine table. Next, we use the using keyword to bring in the stock table for the join operation. After that, the where clause is used to define the condition for the delete. Here, we are joining the medicines table and the stocks table on the medicine underscore ID column to ensure that both tables are related. Finally, we add a condition to check that the expiry underscore date from the stock table is less than or equal to today's date, so that only records for medicines that are either expired or expiring today will be deleted. Let's run the query. There you go. All the desired data have been deleted.
I would love to hear from you. Go ahead and comment below. Did you know we can use delete with using? If so, how many times have you used it? Next, be sure to check out this video on SQL query performance. In this video, I explained how to generate and read execution plan and show an example where we reduce query cost by almost 99.7%. If you want more SQL interview questions like this, let me know in the comment. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. This is Vanish from RebellionRider.com.